Hey guys, how's it going out there? Well, we're up to, unfortunately it's going to be the final video because I'm going to the States in a few days and this is going to be the last chance I get to film. So what I've done today is basically I'm doing a bit of a pump up to show people what to do just before, so you've got a final shoot or you've got some kind of final project. You know, you're going to do a shoot, you're going to do a show, you're going to take off your shirt, you're going to go to the beach, whatever you're going to do. So basically what I'm doing at the moment is just pumping up, and I normally do this for about 2 to 5 minutes before a shoot. And the reason I'm puffing is because I'm pretty tired. I've dropped down to 2 liters of water. If I had have done the final day, what are we up to now? We've done it in 30 days. So this has become, from the 5 week challenge, has become the 30 day challenge. I'm not quite there yet. I'm about 2 or 3 days out. But, you know, got to do the best. Sometimes it's not all going to go to plan. So you got to, that's the best thing about being in condition. You know, if you've got a few more days that you've got to get into shape, or if you're basically in shape all the time and you've got a few days in from the shoot date and suddenly they pull it forward and you've got to do something, you know, 3 or 4 days in advance, you're still ready. You may not be as sharp as you want to be, which is the case with me today. But you can still look okay. So these are my resistor bands and I take them everywhere on the road. Really good when you travel as well. You can use them in the hotel room, just quick sets, doing stuff like that. I might use those for 10 minutes, 15 minutes in the morning, 15 minutes at night if there's no gym in the hotel. And as you can see, I've only been doing that for about a minute and I'm pretty fit, but I'm pretty wrecked. All right, so day 30, what I've done today, I've just put a little bit of oil to show people what oil does to your skin. So in the last couple of videos, we talked about tan. So we've got the tan up and then just a light application of oil or something like that. When it's summer and you go out to the beach, you're probably likely to put some kind of sun cream on, which is a bit oily anyway. So you're going to get the same effect as well as look after your skin. So yeah, basically that's what I've done. And you can see just from that pumping up, my veins have started popping out. And that's what you want to achieve. You want to, in your muscle, you want to start seeing some veins, and you can probably see it in the light better. You know, the definition has definitely come through. And this is still with 2 liters of water. If I had have gone another 5 days, and you know, a lot of people have been asking about water. What is the significance? Why are you drinking so much water when you're trying to get ripped? Well, here's your answer today. I've taken till this final video to explain to people the real reason. Basically what you do, you hydrate your body, you keep drinking and drinking and drinking water, which is actually very good for you. Flushes your kidneys, so it's inner health as well as, you know, hydrating and making your skin look good, all the rest of it. Excuse my lack of breath. But basically what you do, you keep that up for a period of time. So you might drink day in, day out, 3 liters, 4 liters of water. Your mind tells you, your mind has a memory. So as soon as you stop drinking water, your mind is still going to tell you to go to the toilet. So in effect, for the last day when you've got that important job or that important shoot, or you want to look your best, whether it be for yourself or just to be in public or go to the beach, as we mentioned, you just drop your water the, you know, 12 hours before, up to 24 hours before, and you're still going to go to the toilet and drain your body of all that water. Now, I don't suggest that you do this for days and days on end. Obviously, it's very dangerous. But for a period of 12 hours, you'll still continue to go to the toilet because your mind has a memory that's telling it, okay, PJ's about to drink 5 liters of water today, so I'm going to make sure that I flush his system out. But with me not putting that 5 liters of water in, basically you get a really sharp drop. Now, while we're talking about dropping, I started at 91.5 kilos. And today, I really wanted to get down to 81.5 to show that 10 kilo drop. I'm 82.5, so I've dropped 9 kilos in 30 days. Not only that, but I feel good. I've kept my fullness and I'm not gaunt and drawn. So I've done it in a correct way where it's fat loss. There's no cutting corners. I've been eating, as we talked about in the other videos, you eat every 2 hours or 3 hours. You know, you're eating quite a bit of food. You're eating the right food at the right times. You're doing a little bit of cardio at specific moments. All this works really well. If you train hard, you eat really well, and you space out your cardio according to what I've said in the previous videos, you are going to get results. Now, bear in mind, those of you watching the video for the first time, go back and have a look at the first video. There's about five up there now. We've filmed every 5 days. It's really unfortunate I didn't get to do day 35, but that's how it works. This is for people who had about 10 kilos to lose and just wanted to rip up. So you're going to have a look now. This is what I look like today. And bear in mind, now this is now 2 liters of water. I would have liked to have probably gone another day or two and dropped all the water, but I think you can get an idea of, you know, the skin through here, skin through there, the abs coming out, you know, getting a few veins through your body, feeling pretty good. And what I do before I shoot is do some of those things using the resistor bands, some exercises, really pump out the muscles. You know, you can even do simple things like that, just don't have to use any weights. Flexing is really important, so you just hold positions. And all this kind of stuff just gets you more and more in condition. If you actually do things like posing, a lot of bodybuilders do this for day in, day out, for weeks before a show. And what it does, it actually really tightens your body and brings you in even more. The more you pose, the better you're going to look on the day. So if you start doing it as part of your routine, you know, 6 weeks or 8 weeks or 12 weeks or a year before you have to, you know, get in your best shape, you're going to really notice some good results. And you can do simple things like, you know, push-ups. So there's 10 push-ups, you know, and that's straight away, when you're in condition, that'll bring out your chest straight away. All right, catch my breath again. So there we are. We've talked about eating, we've talked about exercise, we've talked about cardio, weights, tanning, oil, conditioning. There's been a lot of things through these videos, and the end result has been 9 kilos dropped, feeling much better, body fat percentage down well under 10%. Probably about 7% at the moment, which is pretty really good condition. Okay, and you'll be able to see a lot of that definition through here. All that definition has come from just training and eating well and getting leaner and leaner and leaner. So even though that's not ideal, you'd be really happy with this kind of conditioning if you had spent only 30 days getting into shape from, you know, being 91.5 kilos down to 82.5. You know, I don't know anyone that would be upset by that. And then you can see the definition through the back as well. There's the Christmas tree coming through here. That's the Christmas tree we talked about. You should be able to see it. It's more pronounced now, I'd say. So there's the back view. And then the side view, you can see a lot of the veins still through here, through there, through the biceps. Skin nice and tight, right through here, lean through the midsection. So I'm pretty happy with my condition. Hopefully these videos have really helped you people out there to, you know, just to inspire you to get into shape. It's not about perfection, but you can clearly see that if you continue this path, if I had another week or 2 weeks or 3 weeks, I'm just gonna get in better and better and better condition. Now, if you've only got 10 kilos to lose, this has taken 30 days. What's 30 days out of your whole life? It's nothing. A month. Imagine doing it for 3 months or 6 months. You know, it's still a very short short period of time. So get out there and give it your best. If you really made a commitment to get fit for the summer, do all your hard work through the winter. Work really hard so that when the first day of summer hits, there you are. You're ready to go. I hope you guys have really enjoyed these videos. Keep sending your comments, and I'll be back again soon. For those of you in the States, I'm heading there in a few days. And yeah, looking forward to some projects coming up in the States. And as always, I'll keep you up to date with Fat and Back and how the documentary is going. Just one thing about the daily pics that people have been asking about. I've actually stopped putting up the daily picks for the moment because I might be using quite a large number of those in the documentary and also an upcoming book. So stay tuned. I'll give you all the information as we get to it. But for now, this is PJ. Thanks for listening and watching. Go and get fit. See you guys.